How are doctors diagnosing people with rheumatoid arthritis? What are the most common blood tests used to diagnose this autoimmune disease? Is it the rheumatoid factor, the ANA or antinuclear antibody test, or the anti-CCP antibodies? Many patients that I see in my clinic have the same questions about their blood work related to possible rheumatoid arthritis. And in this video, I will explain to you what are the most common blood tests in rheumatoid arthritis, what do these tests mean, and how do I use these tests to make a diagnosis of rheumatoid arthritis. Let's begin.
Rheumatologistoncall.com.
Rheumatoid arthritis blood test. When rheumatoid arthritis is suspected, your doctor will order many blood tests. Once you receive the results, if they are abnormal, you will also receive a referral to see a rheumatologist. Now, it may take between 4 to 6 months to see a specialist. And naturally, you will search for additional explanation. And searching on Google is very handy, that's correct. But much of the information that will be available there is usually confusing and scary, and very important for you to understand, it is written by people that are not doctors and do not treat rheumatoid arthritis every day. When to suspect rheumatoid arthritis? Now, if you start having more pain in the hands or feet or other joints, if you notice swelling in the joints, and if you experience prolonged morning stiffness, usually more than 1 hour, then you should be evaluated by a physician, because these signs and symptoms are not usually related to aging. Rheumatoid arthritis tends to affect young people between 30 and 60 years of age, but also elderly. Now, red, swollen, hot joints are suggestive of inflammation, and these signs should prompt you to see a physician who will examine you and then order the following steps to diagnose, like blood tests or x-rays of the joints. What are the rheumatoid arthritis blood tests? Many blood tests can be ordered. Let's discuss the common blood tests for rheumatoid arthritis and what do they mean. Markers of inflammation. We commonly use two blood tests to assess inflammation: erythrocyte sedimentation rate, or ESR, and C-reactive protein, or CRP. In a patient with an active rheumatoid arthritis disease, both may be elevated, which can indicate high levels of inflammation. However, there are patients with rheumatoid arthritis with normal blood tests, and that's confusing, correct? Rheumatoid factor. Rheumatoid factor is the most common blood test ordered when rheumatoid arthritis is suspected. However, this blood test is positive in only 60 to 70% of patients. So even in patients who test negative for rheumatoid factor, they can still have the disease. Sometimes rheumatoid factor can be positive years before the diagnosis, even 10 years before a diagnosis is made. But rheumatoid factor can also be positive in other conditions, such as Sjogren's syndrome or infections, hepatitis B, hepatitis C, lymphomas, and even in normal people. So having a positive rheumatoid factor test does not equal rheumatoid arthritis. And if you want to learn more about rheumatoid factor test, watch this video in my YouTube channel. Anti-CCP antibodies. Anti-CCP, or cyclic citrullinated peptide antibodies, is another test commonly ordered when rheumatoid arthritis is suspected. Anti-CCP is usually ordered along with rheumatoid factor. Is this anti-CCP antibody test better than rheumatoid factor test? They are both appropriate blood tests. This test is positive in only 65% of patients with rheumatoid arthritis. However, the anti-CCP antibody test has a better specificity, over 90%, which means that if the test is negative, the likelihood of having rheumatoid arthritis is minimal. If you test positive for both rheumatoid factor and anti-CCP antibodies, then you most likely have a diagnosis of rheumatoid arthritis or a high chance that you will develop this disease. The presence of anti-CCP antibodies was also shown to be related to a more aggressive form of rheumatoid arthritis and with a poor response to treatment. People who smoke tend to have higher titers of anti-CCP antibodies and a more aggressive disease. So if you are a smoker, this might be the time for you to stop smoking. Other tests. As a rheumatologist, my goal is not only to diagnose people with rheumatoid arthritis, but also to make sure that the diagnosis is correct. I must rule out other diseases that may mimic rheumatoid arthritis. So I order tests to make sure that the people do not have parvovirus, hepatitis B, hepatitis C, tuberculosis, or HIV. ANA test, or antinuclear antibody test, and rheumatoid arthritis. There is an ongoing debate in the rheumatology community if we should or should not order the ANA test when we evaluate a patient for rheumatoid arthritis. Personally, I test all my patients for the ANA test. And here are the reasons for ordering the ANA test when I suspect rheumatoid arthritis. First, I want to rule out other autoimmune diseases like lupus or Sjogren's syndrome. Second, if the ANA test is positive, I know that certain drugs like TNF-alpha inhibitors are better to be avoided. And third, if the ANA test is negative before I treat the patient with TNF-alpha inhibitors, and then the patient develops a side effect like a drug-induced lupus reaction, I know that that ANA test was negative in the past. That is all, my dear rheumatoid arthritis warriors. If you want to learn more, subscribe to my channel and get educated, because knowledge is power. At Rheumatologist on Call, we specialize and we are dedicated to diagnose and treat rheumatoid arthritis patients using today's most advanced methods. But we also have a comprehensive approach that includes genetic assessment, state-of-the-art blood tests, and our approach is unique because we use a holistic approach to focus on nutrition, physical therapy, and mindfulness practices, along with the most advanced treatments to dedicate or to specifically address the needs of patients with rheumatoid arthritis. We treat the whole body and the mind. We treat the patients and not only their disease. If you or someone that you know wants to improve sooner, you can visit our website or contact my office directly to schedule a consultation. And please don't forget to leave your comments in the bottom of this video. And once again, thank you for joining me. I will see you soon.
Rheumatologistoncall.com